Yeah. Are we on?
We are on.
Ahora listo. Shout out to everybody out there Saturday night. I've been singing this song all day. Come to town. Oh, yeah. I think he's singing about you, Riley.
I'm pretty sure he is.
PBT producer.
I guess so.
I do know. Somehow I've got to let my feelings show. She's fresh. Exciting. Y le doy todo el cheque.
She's fresh. Oh my gosh. Exciting.
Hasta le pongo casa. You can't, you like, us, Raza, we can't compliment anybody, right? I mean, no. You're on social media or Facebook, and you compliment somebody. Hey, shout out, se sacó la da, quien sabe qué. And then right away, they comment, mámalo.
Ponle casa.
Ponle casa, déjale cuero.
That's terrible, right?
The
infamous crab effect.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. Hombre, raza.
Big time.
You know how they are. Oh, Raymond Rose says he is absolutely singing about Riley.
You see? He even knows.
Wait till you see her curls today, guys.
Aww.
Yeah. And all I want you to do is just look at her curls. Pórtense bien, cabrones, porque me meto en la cámara aquí y les meto una chinga, cabrón. No estén chingando. Ay, bien jealous.
Real rowdy. Bien rowdy.
Está poniendo necio el rachi.
Big time.
Asústame one time. Yeah, I want to thank, I got the barbacoa shirt on.
I know.
Shout out to the law office of Carlos A. Garcia. He is our exclusive sponsor for Tuesday, Tetera Tuesday, and then Throwback Thursday. So, nos mandó unas shirts, because, you know, we wear shirts and stuff like that. So, nos mandó esta shirt, dije, me la voy a poner ahora. Because anyway, tomorrow morning, you know where we're going, right?
To go get barbacoa.
Exactly. Some big red and nice corn tortillas. And not the corn tortillas that are in the freezer. You have to go to the ice chest, right? The
las
ice.
Que están recién hechas.
Yeah, they're in the ice chest. And you open them and they're like all covered with a towel. And then you just move the towel and then you pick up a damp little pack of homemade tortillas, right?
Yes.
Or those little corn tortillas. And then you get some salsita. And then you pick up a little, you know, this is at La Michoacana, right? You pick up a little aguacate, right?
Yes.
And then you get some rufles, right? You can't forget the rufles. And then you might get a little bit of cilantro también, right? And you come on home. And unos taquitos de barbacoa en la mañana, papá. Unos scrambled eggs también, porque pues chinga, no, you don't want the eggs to get jealous tampoco, ¿entiendes la onda? And asústame one time. El señor Rudo dice que he loves making barbacoa in the slow cooker. Oye.
Yes.
¿Es cocinero el Rudo?
That's hardcore.
Con razón lo quieren. Ya sea.
No, he's a keeper.
Y lengua, Rudo. Lengua. También en la slow cooker. Yeah.
Carmen Benavides, of course she's making menudo.
Yeah.
She's always chatting that she's making amazing things. And it's so true because she sends us pictures of everything. Uh-huh. And I'm like, oh, Carmen. So I totally believe she's making menudo. And so, Carmen, yeah, you're awesome.
Le tiene el viejo bien chiflado en la casa.
Big time. Her whole family is blessed to have her.
And not everybody makes the same type of menudo, you know?
Yeah, I mean, the ingredients are for sure different.
I hate it when I go and I buy some menudo or something, and there's a lot of hominy in it. I mean, that's all there is, just hominy and juice, you know? ¿Unta la panza? ¿Unta la carne? I like it when it's real meaty.
But you see, some people like it the other way around.
Like caldo or what?
No, like with more hominy than the little carnitas.
I mean, no. I mean, mine has to have, there's a secret to having just the appropriate meat in there and the appropriate hominy.
and the appropriate size as well.
Yeah.
Right? Because the size can't be like too big and, you know, like it has to be nicely cut pieces.
And the menudo powder, también, you can't overdo it on that stuff. And you can't underdo it. You don't want it to taste like water. You know what I mean? So there's some people have the perfect hand for that stuff. And some people, pues, they're still struggling. ¿Entiendes la onda?
Mm-hmm.
Pero como quiera, cuando tienes hambre en la mañana, un pinche menudo mientras tenga hominy o lo que sea, ponle agua anything de canal, goes. Carnal.
Anything goes. Anything goes.
Hasta el menudo que prepara agua de canal, carnal. Pero ¿cómo? No hay pedo.
Just mix it with a little bit of lime and it'll be okay.
Con patitas de marrano, dice Mario Flores. I've never, you know what, ladies and gentlemen, I hate to say this, and it might be, you know, sacrilegious or, you know, taboo to say this, pero I've never, ever eaten pig's feet in my menudo. I've never. Have you been?
In the menudo? No, but no. I've tried it.
Uh-huh.
And it's okay. It's pretty good. I mean, just the thought of what it is, it kind of, you know, it's, I'm a little, you know, but I've tried it. It's okay.
Pues es que las hooves son las que están en el soquete todo el día. ¿Entienden la onda? Eso. No sé si se prende medio soquetado, soquetito.
Soquetoso.
Soquetoso. Well, soquete is a valley word. That's a professional valley word, no?
I think so.
It's lodo, right? It's called lodo. That's the way we're supposed to say it in Spanish. In English, it's mud. And in Spanish, es lodo. But here at Professional Valley Talk, es soquete, carnal. Soquete. Es lo que es.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to hashtag PBT Saturday Night Party Live from the My PBT Network Studios, brought to you by Dr. T's Primary Care for Men, IV Vitamin Infusion Therapy. Get that stuff. And it'll boost your immune system, man. It's absolutely fantastic. And
their website is extremely user-friendly. I'm showing it right now. So all they have to do is book their appointment and they're done.
Get to it. Mm-hmm. And they also have testosterone, COVID tests, sermorelin. And ladies and gentlemen, you'll get your flu vaccine free with private insurance. And it's only $20 for cash-based payments. So you could do it at $20 for a flu vaccine or free if you have private insurance. Mm-hmm. And it's Harlingen and Edinburgh, so you can go ahead and do that. Mm-hmm. So he asked me about the flu shot, so I'm going to go get it as well. And he said to get their tri-immune shots when I go get my testosterone. So I'm going to try the tri-immune shot. And that is probably going to be something that's going to make my... You know, fortunately, ladies and gentlemen, I have to say we haven't had any issues with COVID or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
The last time I had a flu, I mean, I don't even remember. How long has it been,
babe? It must have been 2017 December, maybe, or even before that.
Before that. Uh-huh. So it's been years. It's been years. You know, knock on wood, suenan madera un poquito aquí. Pero tengo muchos años que no siento que me ha pegado un flu pesado, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm.
I do have allergies and stuff like that every once in a while, but I'll take a little allergy pill, whatever. But as far as my immune system, you know, and of course exercise, eating right, I don't do anything I'm not supposed to be doing, you know. So, I feel that Dr. T's Primary Care has helped me stay healthy because I've been with him for about 3 years already,
yes,
three or four years.
Been 3-4 years.
So. Make sure to go out there and women, you all can also benefit from it on Thursdays because they have Dr. G's Primary Care for Women. You can call them at 956-441-2188, okay? 956-441-2188 and make sure to start getting healthy, all right? And, you know, if anything can tell us that we need to be healthy, it's what happened this year, you know, because the... COVID was really devastating people with underlying issues and people that hadn't been healthy, obese, overweight, and stuff like that. They were the ones that were more at risk of, dying from this stuff. So, you know, this time it's time to, you know, push a new leaf. It's a new year. It's a new decade. And it's time to tell yourself, where am I going to be in 10 years? In 2030, where am I going to be? Because it's going to get here. And you want to make sure you can make a difference in your, you know, every decade you got to make adjustments. So give them a call, 956-441-2188, Dr. T's Primary Care for Men and for Women as well. So ladies and gentlemen, I was talking about those beautiful those beautiful curls, right? And pues, let me play that song again because I love this song right here. She's so fresh. Ladies and gentlemen, hashtag PVT producer, Rally.
Ooh. Hello, everyone. Hey. So these are my curls. These are my curls.
I love them.
Thank you so much. I do want to send a shout out to everyone on the hashtag PBT chat zone. You all are awesome. I love how everyone just communicates with everyone and says hi to everyone. You guys are so awesome. I really love seeing that. And we love that you guys are here to join us today, tonight. It's a beautiful Saturday. So thank you guys.
You look absolutely stunning.
Oh, thank you.
And I am sure that everybody watching and on the chat zone or in the hashtag PBT chat zone will agree with me and concur. Boy, I can't believe I get to go out with that tonight after we get off. Man, I can't believe it. I'm blessed.
A los tacos.
Asústame one time. We might not wait till tomorrow morning for some barbacoa, papa. Ooh. I want to rest. Asústame one time.
La menina nena, hello, hello. I'm here. Alfredo Rios, Anthony Gonzalez, Sally J. Signs everywhere, Jesus Lopez, Gumesindo Prado, Carmen Benavides. Thank you guys so much for chatting.
Hey, don't forget to join or don't forget to subscribe, okay? Like, share, and comment because, ladies and gentlemen, Thursday we were saying we were short some subscribers to hit 14,400. And we are way past 14,400 today. So,
yes.
I mean, it's amazing the speed that we're moving the show. Mm-hmm. And I think a lot of it has to do with, you know, the live shows. Mm-hmm. I tend to cut out episodes, you know, 5 minute, 3 minute, 4 minute, depending on what it is. And then I upload them during the off days, right?
Yes.
So people can see some of the clips. Now, a lot of people like, somebody commented on one that I put about Pita Studio, right? I cut out a Pita Studio because they had asked on Tuesday night when we interviewed him that why he wasn't in the Astrodome concert.
Oh, yes,
right?
Yes, I remember that.
So I, you know, I edited that little area where he explains why, and I uploaded it. And somebody commented, hey, why did it end or why did it fade out or what, you know, right? Because I don't play the whole interview. It was long. It was about an hour and a half, I think, or 45 minutes. I'm like,
yeah.
So what I do is when I do upload clips of an interview or any show, Rockin' Chaz or Saturday Night Party, all right,
mm-hmm.
in the description, the first thing you see is the link to the entire show, okay?
Yes.
So if you want to see the entire Pita Studio video or interview
mm-hmm.
and you ran into one of those little episodes that are 5 minutes, mm-hmm. you know, all right, just scroll down on the description and hit the link and you get to see the whole thing, all right? Because I can't put the whole thing. I got to put little clips. It's like Joe Rogan. I don't know if any of you follow Joe Rogan. Mm-hmm. He has Joe Rogan clips, JR clips, right?
Yes.
And so JR clips are usually a little, because he's doing an interview for 2 hours, man. He's on for like 2 hours.
Yeah, and some of his interviews go as far as 4 hours.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
So then his producer cuts out clips and then he'll put them up. And if it's real interesting and you want to see more, pues, you know, you go to the link that's in the description and it takes you to the entire interview and you get to watch the whole thing mm-hmm. or listen to the whole thing. Also, another thing, some of you might not be aware because when you watch the YouTube video on your phone, right, you have to have it on to listen to it, right? And if you blacken the screen, right? If you darken the screen, it stops playing, right? Well, what I did is I got the app for YouTube Music. It's about $15 a month. Now, that gives you the capability of, you know, putting on the video and darkening the phone and just listening to it on your AirPods. So you can listen to the entire interview like a podcast on YouTube if you have that app or that, you know, that service. So, you know, something we just want to let you all know about, you know, so in case you want to just listen to the show while you're driving,
mm-hmm.
you know, but Rally, what she does is she plugs in her phone to the stereo of the car and she can leave it on because it's charging and it's airing whatever she wants to listen to over the speakers as well. So that's another way to do it as well. But mm-hmm. as far as subscribers, man, and likes and shares, that helps us out huge. I mean, big time. And we appreciate every single one of you that appreciates the hard work we put into this programming on MyPVT Network.
Yes, thank you.
We have so far 5 live shows per week, all right? Tuesday night, we start at 6 o'clock with Tetera Tuesday. And then after that, Tuesday night live, and we have interviews, headlines. It's more of a little bit more serious type of show.
I'm showing the hashtag PVT My Network, MyPVT Network, sorry, schedule. Uh-huh. Yeah.
And then on Thursday at 6 o'clock, okay, Tetera Tuesday, what we do on Tuesday, it's puro acordeonazo, puro, you know, pura música norteña, tejana, cumbias, you know, para porear, ¿me entiendes? Para prender el bote, prendiendo en el bote. Asústame one time, como dice el Billy Mendoza, para sacar la Round Quarrel.
Yarrow Acro.
Yarrow Acro, Royal Crown, or Crown Royal.
Bien al revés.
And then we do the Tuesday Night Live. And then on Thursday, the throwback, we place music like songs that we haven't heard in a long while, you know, from the 70s, 80s, 60s. You know, it's just songs that everybody likes and knows, and even some songs that you might not be aware of and that you might like, wow, I'd never heard that song. You know what I mean? So that's what we do, Throwback Thursday. And then at night at 8:30, we have the Rockin' Chaz Show. Which, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, I think we affected the NFL ratings this past Thursday with the Kansas City Chiefs Texan game.
Dramatically.
Because they were like 16% below the ratings they had last year. So, hey, Rockin' Chaz le está pegando, carnal. Le están quitando ratings a los NFL. I know a lot of you are looking at the screen going, te lo sico, Rod. But you know what? I've got something to say about that. I don't know how much longer TV ratings are going to be around because,
yeah,
you know, I've got some information on that, and we'll talk about that in just a bit. Let me get to the rest of this because the producer has a structure and a schedule for me to follow, and if I don't do that, she gives me those big, beautiful eyes, real nice and wide. That look that, you know, Robert De Niro does in The Fockers. You know what I mean?
Yes, 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 yes. It's okay. Go ahead. Go.
So be sure to join. And remind me if I forget that. Well, I was talking about this.
I already forgot. Looking at the chat box, too. No, it's okay. It'll come back.
All right. So join our Patreon club. A $25 pledge gets you a special hashtag PVT t-shirt and sticker. And you have the chance of winning in our hashtag PBT weekly drawing for prizes. Now you go to patreon.com, search Rock and Roll James PVT, and our Patreon has just been growing and growing. And man, we really appreciate your support. And don't think that you're just going to get into Patreon and not, you know, get to win anything or get anything in return except us on the YouTube channel. We actually give you a hashtag PVT t-shirt, you know, one of those t-shirts. And then every week we pull out names from the hashtag PVT Patreon memberships and we give them some prizes. We sent out some Air Accordion Tetera Tuesday t-shirts.
We did.
Also, we have some Dr. T's Primary Care swag and a whole bunch of stuff. So make sure if you do join our hashtag PVT Patreon, all right, to send us a message with your address. And if you get into the $25 pledge membership, send us your t-shirt size as well, okay? And that way we can mail you your merchandise immediately, and then you just got to be watching out. And even if you're not watching the show and we pull your name out, you'll probably receive something in the mail and go like, what is this? Wow, why did I get this? Well, if you get something in the mail and you're a viewer and you've been in our Patreon, it's not by surprise. It's because we pulled your name out and you were part of our membership. So we thank you so much.
And okay? I include a little note saying you are this week's hashtag PBT Patreon pledge winner.
Oh, so, okay. Yeah, all right.
So they'll know.
Órale. Oye, tengo una producer que tiene todo covered, papá.
I'm telling you.
So we also have Cash App, $ Rock and Roll James, okay? And we have a shirt. Let me pull the shirt out.
Yes.
You can get this shirt. We still have some left. We're out of 3XL, though. We have small, medium, large, extra large, and 2XL left.
Yes.
But it's the Air Accordion. Okay? It's the Air Tetera Tuesday Air Accordion. This is a shirt we wear every Tuesday at 6 o'clock because ponemos pura música de acordeón, papa. Y podía Javi, nos ponemos a hacer un pinche acordeonazo, papa. We start playing, you know what I mean? And Wyo Cruz on our chat zone, he gave me a hell of an idea, okay?
What was the idea? Are you going
to
share?
The idea is to have an air accordion contest.
Ooh.
So what we're going to do, and we're going to put this together, and we'll probably announce it on Tuesday, maybe.
Okay.
Everybody,
I'm excited already.
Everybody that has a Tetera air accordion t-shirt can do a little video, you know, 10 seconds.
Yeah, I was like, oh, shit.
30 seconds at the most. So you can text it to us, right? Or send it to us on our hashtag PVT Facebook.
Uh-huh.
But do a little video of you doing some air accordion to some accordion music. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And then we're going to have an air accordion contest. And then the winner will send them $100 on Cash App or whatever. Okay?
Video's over. We'll show it to you. It's right behind Rock. And then they sent us a 3D visualization lamp, which also we're going to show right now. He's just opening it up so that way you can see what it is. Because we're like, what is it? What is it? What is it? And so it's a really cool Dallas Cowboy helmet that lights up. It's an LED light and it changes colors, and we have it here in our studio, and it's super 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 duper cool. So we do want to thank them so much for always thinking of us. I mean, you guys don't have to do this, but you know, thank you all so much. You all are amazing. And the last thing, I think I revealed this last week, but they did send me a cup that says world's greatest producer. Mm-hmm. So you all are super duper amazing. We really appreciate everything that you do, you know, to make us happy and for thinking of us. So thank you guys so much. And so can you show them, babe?
Yeah.
So just point to them.
Right here.
Don't drop anything, please.
Yeah, we got these cups right here.
Yes.
And then the lights up here.
Yes.
The lights up here, but we've got that little Dallas Cowboy helmet, that mm-hmm. lunchbox, $6 million man.
Yes.
We've got all kinds of stuff that fans have sent us. The books, the little wrestling figures.
The WWE encyclopedia.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, and then that microphone is made out of something that was on a cake.
Yeah.
So they sent us a cake that was celebrating my 30 years. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, it just keeps going, growing and growing. We have the mm-hmm. Delavan, Wisconsin cap up there. So mm-hmm. we appreciate it. It's awesome to be able to collect all this stuff from everybody that's from everywhere.
Yes.
You know?
And also, I do want to say thank you to everyone who submits their pictures. The hashtag PBT Patreon pledge members, when they receive their t-shirts, they take a picture of themselves with the t-shirt on. And, you know, it's really awesome to see that they're like barbecuing, like they use it as like a dressy shirt. Right. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to share with you guys also some of our hashtag PBT fan pics. And I know we got a text and someone says, Riley, you never put my picture in. Guys, just wait. So I promise I have it saved in a little folder. And
se ponen
I said,
bien feelings.
Yeah, super feelings. And so I reassure them that I did not forget. It's coming. And so like Rock was mentioning, every live show, you know, we have structure and stuff like that. So on Saturdays is usually the day that I input those hashtag PBT fan pics. So let me go ahead and share with you guys. This one, this is a handsome man. His name is Chris Bencourt. He is from Porter, Texas, and he's been supporting us for a long time as well. So Chris Bencourt, thank you so much. I love the selfie. I love when they send selfies. They look really nice.
Yeah.
We also have Victor Martinez from La Feria, Texas. And I love this. He's just like hanging out by the barbecue pit, drinking a beer, you know, barbecuing, enjoying life. And he's wearing a hashtag PBT.
Está prendido del bote y con el bote prendido. That's what we call it.
And he's happily wearing a hashtag PBT t-shirt as well. And this picture is really awesome. I love it. So our friends from Round Rock, Texas, Felipe Menchaca, he sends us a picture of him eating caldito. By the way, we were starving when he sent it to us. So he sent us a picture of him eating caldito de res, it looks like, right? With cabbage and papas. papitas and corn and all that, and he's watching hashtag PBT. So again, thank you guys so much. You all are you guys are amazing, and we love seeing all of y'all's pictures, and thank you so much.
Y el señor Rudo. Well, babe. Because I said, hey, and you go, well, babe.
Hi.
All right. Okay. What's next? Oh, we have the Jaime Dianda accordion giveaway contest. And I called the management, and I was like, oye, dude, ¿cuándo vamos a hacer el giveaway del accordion, bro? Porque ya se, desde July lo estamos haciendo, ¿no? Pero he told me, Rock, we have very few tickets left.
Yes.
And we're looking probably at the first week of October. So we've got about 2 weeks to buy a ticket to be able to win an autographed Jaime Dianda accordion, one of his favorite accordions. We've got the spot right here so you can find out more information on it. Check it out.
Johnson 77 Music and My PBT Network present the Jaime Dianda Accordion Giveaway. Tickets will go on sale beginning August 3rd, 2020. Only 200 tickets will be available, and you get to pick your number. Raffle ticket buyers will receive a text to their cell phone guaranteeing the number that they picked. The winner will be randomly chosen and announced live on the My PBT Network YouTube channel. There is no limit on how many numbers you can buy. The Jaime Dianda Accordion Giveaway. For all info and other questions, contact Julian Johnson at julianbigj@yahoo.com. Or follow Jaime Dianda on social media at facebook.com/JaimeDianda1979 or Instagram at Jaime_Dianda79. Own Jaime Dianda's personal accordion. The Jaime Dianda Accordion Giveaway.
What's that?
Can I show the accordion?
Yeah, show
just
the accordion.
Just like a still image of the accordion.
Yeah, we got it.
It's a Gamarelli.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a beauty.
Nombre está bruta.
It's a beauty.
It
I
is.
I love it. It's
it is
beautiful.
Beautiful, yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's and super nice.
The good thing about it is he's also going to throw in a case that you can keep it in. And it'll be autographed as well.
Oh, he's autographing it?
Yeah, he's autographing the accordion and the case. And and let me tell you, the best thing about it is to have something to put it in to take care of that thing. You don't want to get that. You don't want that amazing piece of instrument to be scratched or nothing like that. I mean, you want it to be in mint condition.
Yes.
So when it's delivered to you in a in an anvil case, autographed, I mean, you have something to put it in. So go to his Instagram and let's finish up those tickets. Maybe we can give it away before October, but they're going to give it till October 1st, okay? Mm-hmm. And you go to Jaime_Dianda1979 on Instagram, and you can get all the details on that. And you get to pick the number, right? There's it was 1 through 200.
I like that.
And they'll tell you, if you go to his Facebook, he'll have a list of all the people that have bought a ticket and have chosen their number, so you know which number, and then you get contact them and you can get your number. Okay, so good luck to everybody.
I like that they allow you to pick your own number, because you know how some of us are, we lean towards, you know, our favorite number, and this number means like all these things in our life, and they get to pick the number. So that's awesome. Someone was asking if he's going to autograph the case, and yes, he will autograph the case, right? It's a case?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like one of these.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know if it's exactly the same material or whatever, but this is an anvil case, you know, right? And it's a Gator case actually, but they're known as anvil cases. And I have guitar amps in there. And like expensive ones, and so you know I need to take care of them, and I didn't want the guys in my band to be carrying the amps around, or I didn't want to be carrying them around. I usually handle all that stuff, so I got these cases, and it's the orange amps are in mint condition in there, except for like when, you know, when we open them up to play on stage, and By the way, we're going to be playing September 30th.
I cannot wait. I'm extremely excited about that show.
Me too.
I'm extremely excited. I'm extremely excited to see the guys again.
Yeah.
I'm extremely excited to see you guys perform. Mm. I know that you guys shine, all of you guys, JR, Joey, Franco, Mauro, you, and everybody.
And even our Ray Abrego.
Yes, of course. Ray, and, he's the one that makes it all happen, yeah. Honestly, on stage. I can't wait to see everyone.
And not only him as well, but Sergio, Sergio, you know, our video guy.
Yes.
Because I send everybody a text because we're in a group chat, right? In a group mm-hmm. text, like, well, September 30th, Whiskey D Live. Uh-huh. And like Sergio was like, yeah, right away, you know, yes. He right away responds. But yes. But we're really excited. We haven't played in a little while. And I don't think we're even going to rehearse to play, which I don't think we need to because we're like brothers. I mean, yeah. We're connected, yeah, you know, so we get on stage and we tear it up.
Yeah. Right? Y'all's chemistry is obvious when they see you guys, honestly, like you guys yeah. are amazing.
We'll give you details on Tuesday night. We'll put up the poster and everything so y'all can know where we're going to play. So that way you can go. And by the way, we're going to take our hashtag PBT cameras.
Yes.
Because Sergio's going to be there filming and stuff. Sergio. And then we're going to make a video and show it to everybody on this channel. Okay. So make sure to subscribe in case you're not. Okay. Yes. We were talking about the NFL ratings. It said the NFL season opener primetime matchup between the victorious Kansas City Chiefs and the Houston Texans snared 19.3 million viewers on NBC, which, you know, I think that's pretty damn good, you know. But it says that's a fumble of 12.3% from the Green Bay Packers-Chicago Bears opening game of the year before.
Mm-hmm.
That was on September 5th, 2019. And, you know, they were saying racial justice center stage at the beginning of the game and contest between the reigning super champions and stuff like that, you know. But I honestly think that YouTube and all the other streaming services have a lot to do with it, with people not watching TV anymore.
Yeah, that's true.
Because when you have satellite, when you had satellite television, you had a certain amount of channels depending on what package you had, right? Yes. The more you pay, the more shopping networks you get, right?
Yes. Oh, my God, those yeah. things.
And now there's another thing that's going on, all right?
What?
So you had a certain amount of channels when you mm-hmm. had satellite or cable. And then and now with YouTube, you have so much content that a satellite package doesn't come near, you know, what they can offer, what YouTube offers, right? And then you have Netflix, which, by the way, is going through some really, it's going through some issues right now because of a show that they have called Cuties or something like that.
I heard about that.
The French show. And I don't want to explain about it too much here because I don't want to give it anything, any type of, you know, promotion or anything. But there was on Twitter, there was a hashtag cancel Netflix trending, you know. So you've got Netflix, you've got a lot of other, you know, streaming services. And then you also have Fire Sticks. And some of those Fire Sticks can be fixed to where you get everything, you know. And so that all together is messing up the ratings for these NBCs and all this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So, and now also, ladies and gentlemen, last year, or I think it was the past 2 years,
mm-hmm.
I would watch the NFL on YouTube. I wasn't watching the games except for the Dallas Cowboy game. Porque por el pinche Cowboy ese game no me lo voy a perder. Carnal, tiene la onda, asústame one time. So I'd watch that. And, but my dad came one time, and I told him, hey, Dad, I'm watching football, okay? Orale, está bueno. We sat down on YouTube, and he was like, there's football right now? I go, no, no, mira. So we went on YouTube, and we saw, like, 6 games within an hour and a half, you know, because they're condensed in plays.
Like highlights.
Yeah, it's right? like highlights, mm-hmm. but it's not some sports guy telling you, well, and so threw the ball over here. Mm-hmm. It's like watching the game. You're hearing the sportscasters, the analysts, and the play-by-play guy in the booth. And so it's like watching the game, and you're just like seeing the plays that made a big difference in the game. And you know, those 10, 15 minute videos had us at the edge of our seat, you know, watching them. And so my dad was like, when we finished, my dad was like, wow, got to watch all those games. I'm like, yeah, dad. I mean, that's what's going on now.
Yep.
So I have no idea where this television thing is going. Of course, they got to check out the streaming and all that for the games. But we'll see what happens with the NFL this year. You know, a lot of people, they were making a big stink because, you know, the players, they held arms like in the middle and that apparently a bunch of, we didn't get to watch it, ladies and gentlemen, because we're doing the Rock and Chaz show. We weren't watching the game, but the stadium started booing at them.
Yep.
And so a lot of people were like, well, we're trying to promote peace and this and that. And so they were kind of upset about that. And I told this guy, you know what? I think it's just that most people already, like, they're thinking to themselves, okay, we got the message. You
like,
know?
Yeah.
Yeah, because this whole social justice thing has been going on for, man, like, since April or no, since May, since the George Floyd thing, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's been going on since May. Every single day, everybody's getting reminded of it. The sports world is reminding everybody when they said, you know what, we already saw that. Let's watch some sports. Then they turn on the sports and then boom, then they turn on commercials or they go into a program and they start with that. So I think people were like, okay, we've got the message. And when that happened, I'm assuming that they were like, okay, we've had enough of this. Just play football.
Yeah, so. Sal in the house, he does comment. He's like, nah, people are tired of the athletes being that way. Like, yeah. You know, it's
yeah, because it's like people like sports is an outlet. You go to a game to have some popcorn, enjoy some a game with your kids, and you know, and see them compete and you know, do what
it's
they do, what
time,
they
get,
what
you know?
They're getting paid for. But you know, I'm assuming that's my personal opinion that I think people, because people were saying, man, I can't believe all those racist people were booing. And I was like, I don't think it's because they're racist. I think it's because they probably want to tell them, we got the message already, man. Let's just play.
Yeah,
right?
Like,
let's
we get it. Let's move on. I'm here to watch favorite sport.
Yeah. Aparte de esto, we're going to work on this. Mm-hmm. Let's try to figure it out and fix it. But, you know, maybe I'm wrong. I don't know what you all think about that. But And another thing, they apparently had two different national anthems. One for, I guess, a black national anthem and then an American national anthem. And I saw that and I was like, okay, so is it two different countries now or is it what? I don't understand. Mm-hmm. You know, we're all supposed to come together under one nation, under, you know, under one flag. But I have no idea where it's going. But, you know, hopefully it'll mellow out a bit. But the Texans got their ass kicked, and see, I'm not a Texan fan.
Neither
and
am I.
And during football season, all my Texan friends, we start throwing smack at each other.
Yes.
And it's something that I like about football, is that it's like politics, right?
Yeah,
you know, if you're a Biden supporter, you're a Trump supporter, te vas a echar mosca, y te vas a echar, you know.
Yeah. I love when your friends like send you messages and make videos specifically to like shit on you because of the Cowboys.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
Like,
hilarious.
Like that rowdy Texan, remember in the past video?
Uh-huh.
When the Texans beat the Cowboys and he came on Facebook Live. Que Rock, contas, pinche Rock.
You haven't posted nothing.
Que PBT, que la chingada, que todo lo otro. So he's like telling me off.
Yes.
And I recorded the so he deleted it because he was like buzzing, you know, and then I was making fun of him, right? Mm-hmm. And he was without a shirt and everything. If you look back in the library, just search hashtag PVT Texan hater, I think. Texan hater.
Yes.
And the dude will come up. It's freaking hilarious.
It's so hilarious.
So now he was hoping to get rid of it, but I have it, so I remind him every time,
time.
On social media. Hello, pongo, carnal.
Blackmail.
Gabriel Mendieta es el tío de los de Conteño. No Conteño. De
Retoño.
Retoño. Okay. Es el tío de Samuel Ramos y los hijos de Samuel Ramos. Yeah, they're a great band. And as a matter of fact, you know, we do. Let me play it.
Yeah, let me say hi to a couple of people that are on the chat box real quick, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Sal in the house, of course. Mario Flores, La Menina Nena, Alfredo Rios, and Janie Rios as well. Michael Torres, life is good. Life is good. Life is always good. Anthony Gonzalez from our friends from Flint, Michigan. So thank you guys for always supporting us as well. Manu Garcia, Victoria Garcia, Laura Ohio, Jesus Lopez. I haven't seen that name on the chat box, but thank you for joining. Miguel Ramirez and Mad T Yahoo. So thank you guys.
This is a song from Retoño. They're one of my favorite bands. The very first time I heard this song, I brought it and I played it for Rally in one of the bedrooms, and we started dancing right away together.
Yeah. I love it.
And we just bounced to it really good. Grupo Retoño, man. They're a great band. And they're like, they got music in their blood. Their dad, Samuel Ramos. La military cerca de Brownsville. And humble kids too.
They're so awesome.
Campanitas de amor, siento mi corazón cuando estás tú conmigo.
No más.
Yo no sé, pero yo siento que soy feliz.
I love the voices.
Se avientan.
Campanitas de amor. Siento dentro de mí. Cuando me das un beso.
Así siento yo, babe. Campanitas.
Ese es mi fe. De vivir para ti. Yo por eso te quiero.
No más.
Campanitas de amor. Siento mi corazón, campanitas de amor, sueño.
Hey,
cuando...
you know what's a good idea?
What?
Interviewing them.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They'll do it. They're
I'll
awesome.
Give them a call. I hired them for a San Benito show.
Mm-hmm.
Because, ladies and gentlemen, we're capable of putting festivals together for you, the entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
So
stage,
if you're going to do a festival, once they start letting, you know, letting people or letting cities do festivals,
mm-hmm.
And San Benito hired us to put a festival together, give us a budget. And I decided to put a little bit of everything, a country band. I put them, and they wanted Garcia Brothers. So I hired Garcia, mm-hmm. and then we needed another band. I thought, man, Retoño, they're from the San Benito area, man.
Campanitas de amor, siento dentro de mí, cuando me das un beso.
Y se avientaron esa noche, man.
Engrandeces mi fe,
They have this song called Samuel's Medley. It's got to be from their dad.
That song reminds me of my dad because he knows how to play that on the accordion.
Yeah.
David
Lee Garza made this song
uh-huh.
famous.
Oh, okay.
So these are Samuel songs, which is their dad.
This is regreso.
Retoño.
Cuántas noches de vino y desvelo, esperando a ver si con el tiempo se cerraba esta herida que tengo.
Man, they sound great.
Sin tener de ti ni una noticia, pretendiendo el haberte olvidado. Cansado y tú de mí te has acordado. ¿Hasta cuándo va a terminar esta pena? ¿Cuándo me voy a librar de estas cadenas? Y a mi pecho herido no encuentra el alivio. Mi única esperanza es que vuelvas conmigo.
La Tetera Tuesday Sherbet.
And if you want one, Cash App is $30. Dollar sign, Rock and Roll Jeans.
Yeah. $30 Cash App.
Yes.
$ Rock and Roll James. And make sure to put your shirt size and your address. We only have small, medium, large, extra large, and 2XL.
And really quick, if there's a Jose Jimenez, he might be el primo. I don't know. But Jose Jimenez.
El primo es Roberto Pulido. Babe.
Ah, okay. Sorry. No, el primo mío.
Ah, okay.
So, Jose Jimenez, if you're out there, if you're listening, please send us your address. He sent us like a message, but he didn't send us.
Who's that?
Jose Jimenez.
Okay.
Yeah, so just send us a message, please, Jose. Dale. Jimenez.
All right. Let me get this other song on.
Oh, I do want to send a special shout out. Ooh, 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 ooh. So this is to Rick and Mike, and they're out at Quelite Ranch barbecuing, having a couple of cold ones. So thank you all, Rick Moreno and Mike, out at Quelite Ranch. Hey, y'all gotta invite us out there. We wanna go to the ranch.
So this past Tuesday, we had Pete Astudillo on.
Are we doing the hashtag PBT weekly recap?
Yeah. So we're doing the hashtag PBT weekly recap. Yeah, there we go. Sorry. Thank you for putting me in line, Mama. So after months and months of receiving or getting Pete Astudillo's voicemail, we finally set up an interview with him, and which is the way you're supposed to do it. You know, I was never expecting him to answer the phone when I'd call him off the whim, you know, nomás de repente. You know, porque pues no está, nadie contesta el teléfono, ya, nadie lo contesta, textean. And then sometimes you call somebody or you text them and they never respond, and then you go on social media y los miras ahí por todo social media. ¿Sabes qué está en el pinche teléfono? Answer my text, güey.
Right?
They're ignoring me. No, pero es que también entras en el Facebook y la chingada, ¿me? So anyway, we got a hold of Pete and we talked to him and we just, it was an amazing interview, and there were some really funny moments in the chat zone, because Pete, while we were never able to get a hold of him because of his voicemail, right? Once we did, nunca se cayó el vato.
The chat box, I swear, I couldn't. I had to, like, move the mic. I'm like, you guys?
The chat zone. And then they were screwing with me, too. Because, yes. Pues, you
Qué
know,
malos.
Pete was going on and on and on, right?
And it was an amazing story.
Oh, yeah, estaba bruto.
It was amazing.
It's great.
Mm-hmm.
And pues yo estaba, yeah. 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 So then they started a freaking countdown of all my yays. Yes. And I looked over there, and I was, I think Big D started it. Who started it?
I don't know. I don't know if it was Big D or Sal in the house. I don't know. But then everyone just started
yeah.
counting them down.
And then so, so I'm looking at, because we have a big screen TV right here. I'm looking at all the chat, right? And then I'm looking at, I'm listening to Pete. I'm going, yeah, yeah. And then I look over there, number 27,
oh,
yeah. yes.
And you know what was so funny? What was so funny was that we were, you know, I was also chatting like, guys, don't forget to like or whatever. Like, we're almost at 200, right?
Uh-huh.
So then someone says, wait, 200 yes or 200
yeah.
watching? I'm like, oh my God, they were something else. You guys are hilarious. I was back here laughing and laughing. Yeah. I had to roll my chair that way, like, oh.
And I was having
God.
A hard time, you know. I needed to keep focused and listen to what the hell Pete was talking about so I could be able to respond, you know? Y estaba viendo ya el desmadre en el pinche chat box, en el chat zone. And then the funny thing was, you know, I saw it and I said, ah, la madre, am I saying yeah too much?
Yeah.
So I'm like, mm-hmm, okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then BD puts, I think he caught on.
He's saying, yeah. No, what were that? What were you? What
he's
you
saying? Okay.
Something. Now he's saying,
and he's
okay.
Saying, and he's humming. I think he caught on.
Oh, my goodness. Well, Sal in the house says 50 yes from Rock. You see?
Pero pues, I was like, well, what? I'm letting Pete talk, and I want to make sure that he knows I'm still on the line.
El vato va a pensar
que se colgó el pinche phone o algo.
No, and you know what? When I hate when you do that to me, like, not when you say yeah, but when I'm talking to you and you're just You don't say anything. Uh-huh. So it's.
Are you listening?
Are you listening? Are you listening? You're not even replying. You're not saying, yeah, okay, okay, yeah, uh-huh. You're not saying anything. So it's only respectful when someone's talking to you or they're trying to tell you something.
You tell them, babe.
That you respond, uh-huh, yes.
Regáñalos.
Okay, yeah. And so I'm like, and so we were cracking up, right? But I'm like, how are you just supposed to stay extremely quiet? Then he's going to think you're not like into his conversation. And you really were. We all were. But I guess he just got caught up in the... And, you know, in the conversation or listening, you're like, yeah, yeah.
And then yeah. Another thing is like, you know, Pete was just talking and talking, right? And yeah. and saying some really cool information.
Oh, my God.
And then somebody puts on there, can you get a hold of Mr. Quintanilla so he can tell Pete to shut up like in the movie?
Someone also said, I'm going to take off, get something to eat. I'll come back. And he's still going to be talking. Yeah. And then someone says, Rally's going to be teaching tomorrow morning and Rock's still going to be on the phone with Pete. Yes. I'm like, oh, my gosh, you guys are terrible.
But they were all that. Tell him, ask him how he felt when Mr. Quintanilla told him to shut up in the movie. And we mentioned it to him and he goes, dude, it was the only, they told me, okay, you got this one line in the movie, Pete, okay. And they told me to shut up. You shut up.
Oh my goodness. That was hilarious.
Yeah, it was fun. But ladies and gentlemen, it was this past Tuesday night. I've been putting up episodes of it. So you might want to check out the show. If you see one of the episodes on there that has Pete on there, he talks about Selena. He talks about why he wasn't at the Astrodome. He also talks about No Me Queda Más. I never knew that song was actually pitched to Maz because him and Ricky Vela were collaborating and writing music and writing songs. And Ricky Vela wrote that song and he wrote Estúpido Romántico together with them. So they sent Maz three songs and Maz didn't want it. They returned it back. So that's when they said, you know what, why don't we let, you know, give it to Selena. And Pete thought that it was an amazing song for her to do, and the rest is history, mm-hmm. you know. But little things like that you would never know, you know, and mm-hmm. like the destiny of things, you know.
Yeah.
You know, some things were just meant to be, and they weren't meant to be the other way, the way they were trying to make it be. Yeah. You know what? That song never belonged to Maz. It belonged to Selena.
Yep.
You know, mm-hmm. and I think she's the only one that could have delivered it in that manner and made that song what it was and what it is. Mm-hmm. And it's one of the most iconic songs. And the video is one of the most iconic videos as well, which mm-hmm. I personally know the producers, Diego and Sean, who are the producers of Puro Tejano. Those videos you see of me interviewing Selena and all that, the guys behind the camera, they were two young guys that were very, very ambitious. And they were very, very fond of Selena as well. And they formed an awesome relationship with Mr. Quintanilla and AB. And it was just an awesome relationship we had. And they offered to do the video. They asked him, can we do Selena's video for No Me Queda Más? And they got the blessings from the Quintanilla family. And boy, they knocked it out of the park. To just think, I mean, when you watch the video, the whole beginning of it, you know, she's in the restaurant and she gets a note and all that. And then it turns into that, you know, awesome staircase. And I mean, just to be able to have visualized all the parts and everything that goes into that video. I mean, those guys did an amazing job and they were so young and they were just so, it was so, so creative. And it was just something that. Hey man, I'm just amazed that I was even a part of it, you know, and I'm blessed that I was. So awesome.
Can I share one of those videos of Pete and Selena?
Yeah.
I know I didn't get to show it on Tuesday, but I really wanted to show it today. So they're here dancing.
That was something I wanted to ask mm-hmm. Pete, but, you know, I failed to ask him about the dancing. Mm-hmm. I mean, Pete, you know, he didn't know just... He didn't just have the ability to write songs and mm-hmm. sing. He also had some dance moves, man. And he would dance with Selena on stage and they mm-hmm. looked great together. Selena was an amazing dancer, you know. And it's just like, golly, man, just absolutely fantastic. Mm-hmm. And some great times back in the day, you know.
It's so much fun watching them.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, man. Look at that. I mean, they were just like... It's just an amazing thing. And Pete also, a lot of people don't realize where he comes from. He wasn't born in Laredo. He wasn't born in Laredo, was raised there. And then he was into he was in the restaurant business as well. And they were migrants. And, I mean, just so much great information about Pete Astudillo, who just had an amazing contributor to Selena y Los Dinos. And it's just, you know, it's just an amazing guy, man. And he's a great, humble guy, too, as well, man.
Yeah.
We used to hang out, and the next interview we're going to do with him, it's going to be here. He's going to come over, and we're going to hang out. Yes. Or we'll go over to Laredo and hang out at his pad or something. Mm-hmm. And then we'll go out about throughout the night, go hang out, and then we'll take video, and we'll make a badass freaking show about it, right? Mm. So that's why you got to subscribe, because you never, you know, right now we're doing phoners. But once this thing's over, we'll be going to San Antonio. We'll be going to Laredo, anywhere, Corpus. I talked to AB. AB's interested in doing the show as well. So I'm really excited. I'm really excited, man. Really excited. All right. By the way, we also had local promoter Nano Ramirez on the show Tuesday night. We talked to him for the first 15 minutes. And he spoke about some concerts. And he says that the last concert he had before they shut everything down was John Party. And he was going to be, I think it was March or April. Mm-hmm.
I think it was April.
And the two nights were sold out here locally in McAllen. Mm-hmm. So then they said, we need to reschedule. So they said, how about October? So he said, how about June? And they said, we can't do June, October. So it's supposedly they rescheduled for October. And we'll see how it goes. He said that they sold out both shows and that nobody returned their ticket. Nobody asked for a refund.
A refund, yeah.
Nobody. Mm-hmm. And I said, why do you think that is? He goes, because they know if they would have asked for a refund and then the show pops up again and they come back, they're going to have to pay more for the ticket.
Yep.
So apparently it's rescheduled for October. They're supposed to make an announcement this week, past week. So
I hope so.
Or this coming week, something like that. Mm-hmm. But we're letting the cat out of the bag then. So,
you know,
sorry about that, Nano. All right. Okay. Chaz Corona. If you don't watch the Rockin' Chaz show on Thursday night, I want to invite everybody personally to check it out because me and Carlos Corona, he's from San Benito, and we go back a long time, and we worked at the rock radio station together, and we're like the last three left. I'm the only one left now.
Mm-hmm.
And it's funny because they changed before, you know, COVID, you know, they ended up, the company had to start, you know, letting people go for COVID and putting them, you know, laying them off and stuff.
Furlough.
It was me and Charlie, and me and Charlie started this Rock and Chaz show on the social media page, and it ended up moving to the MyPVT network. So he still comes in and he brings in these collectibles, and he brought in this album from Marky Ramone, or was it Joey or Mark? What was the name?
Marky Ramone. Let me show him.
Yeah, he's a drummer for the Ramones, and he had a band before. And the album had skulls on it, and it was like the first album to ever have skulls on it back in 1971 or 72. Mm-hmm. But freaking Charlie has all this knowledge about stuff.
Big time.
And me and him, it's like my wife freaks out because me and him get together, and it's like we toss knowledge at each other of stuff that nobody really knows, you know?
Yeah.
I knew that me and Charlie were going to be like that, you know? Because I mentioned Marty Robbins, and I was singing Cool Clear Water for Marty Robbins. Cool Clear Water, right?
Yeah.
And when I was singing it, because my wife, this is what happens with me, folks. My wife, she hates this.
Oh my God.
And sometimes she doesn't like it, but it makes her laugh.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So
it depends on the mood I'm in.
Yeah.
Okay, so go.
Like if she'll say, babe, are you going to the kitchen? Yeah. Can you bring me some water? And I'll go, cool, clear water.
So anything I say or I ask for, it instantly comes with a line
of a song,
a lyric of a song. And I'm like, how do you know all of the lyrics of every song on the planet?
Yeah, so I was singing the song. And
and then Charlie goes,
Marty Robbins, Gunfighter Ballads album.
I'm like, what?
All day I face the barren waste.
I was like, what? You know that song?
Cool water. Old Dan and I with throats burned dry and souls.
Babe, can you bring me some water?
For water.
Are you going to the kitchen? Can you bring me some water, babe?
Cool, clear water.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
And then he's got another one, man. Oh, well, this is the most popular one for Marty Robbins.
I love that song. That song reminds me of your dad.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm. Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl.
And then another one of my favorite songs from the Marty Robbins Gunfighter Ballads, which, by the way, the reason I know this music is because my dad had the album. And the album was in our big old coffin-style stereo when I was a kid. And the album cover always, like, amazed me, man. I was, like, third, fourth grade. And it was, like, a dude dressed all black, a black hat, and, like, a gunfighter, like, going for his six-shooter. And it was Marty Robbins dressed up, man. He looked great. And it was a red album with him, like, outlined on there. Uh-huh. And it was called Gunfighter Ballads and Prairie Songs or something like that.
Yeah.
And the first time I decided to hear that record as a kid, this song came on. And it's a story about a ranger going into an old west town and going after a dude, you know, an outlaw. And he was going up against a guy with a big iron, you know, which is what they call the... Which is what they call the six shooter or the gun, right?
Yeah.
To the town of our free, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say.
Yeah, he just walked in, hadn't much to say.
No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town.
Boy, you can visualize it.
He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip.
So when I would hear these songs as a kid, I was visualizing the movie.
In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red.
Texas Red.
Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead.
Ah, pesado con el cohete, el vato.
He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24. And the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 more. 1 in 19 more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around.
Boy.
Was an Arizona Ranger, wouldn't be too long in town.
Arizona Ranger?
He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red.
Yeah. That's a cool story. I love it. Marty Robbins. You could probably find it on the all-time greatest hits. He's got a lot of cool songs. The guy died of cancer at a very young age, in 1970-something. But one of the greatest, man. I love this song. Watch, check this out. This is another song that I love to listen to. Man, it's called a white, let's see if it's in here.
Mm-hmm.
White sports coat. A white sports coat. And a let's see.
I want to send a shout out to Alex Guajardo 777. He says shout out to El Chiefy de Alton, Texas.
El Chiefy, what's up, Chiefy?
Yeah. Mark Anthony says I have two brand new pairs of Stacey Adams that I haven't worn, but I need more. That's me. I'm like buying shoes left and right. I'm not even like physically going to work.
This one. Los 50s.
Mm-hmm.
A white
sports coat and the pink carnation.
Pues bien slick el vato.
I'm all dressed up for the dance.
Hoy no más. Va pa' lo baile.
A white sport coat.
Con los Stacy Adams del jefe. El diamante de San Antonio.
I'm all alone in romance. Once you told me long ago, to the prom with me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will hold my dream of
white sports coat. Yeah. Good stuff, man, right there.
Yes.
Classic. You get to hear everything around here, man. I'm into all kinds of music.
Mm-hmm.
So, ladies and gentlemen, make sure to join us Tuesday, 6 o'clock, hashtag PBT, the Teta Tuesday mix, and hashtag PBT Throwback Thursday mix. Mm-hmm. And Tuesday Night Live. And the Rock and Chaz Show, all right? And we're going to be right back. We're going to take a quick 30-second break for Dr. T's Primary Care for Men.
In response to our current COVID-19 situation, Dr. T's Primary Care is offering discounted prices on our IV vitamin infusion therapy for all frontline workers, law enforcement, and any male or female patient looking to improve their immune system. Not only do we offer PCR testing for COVID, but we also offer safe and natural solutions to improve your health. Call 956-441-2188 and ask about our discounted IV vitamin infusion therapy. Follow us on Facebook for up-to-date information. Call 956-441-2188.
I can't wait for the barbacoa tomorrow. I'm excited. I want aguacate and barbacoa.
This shirt is probably being subliminal with people.
Big, you know, time.
Like they're watching the show and then they're tomorrow morning they're gonna get up and go get barbacoa because they saw it on their screen all night.
Yeah.
Right? For a couple of hours. How many people we got watching, babe?
Right now we have 150. Wait, hold on. 145?
All right.
So
we have hashtag PVT, three questions for the fans. Yeah. We're almost done here.
Hold on. I'm not
ready. You're not ready? Three questions for the fans. Yeah.
There you go. Over here, was you ask me how many, so I'm looking and then I refresh. And like, ah!
Sorry, Mom.
It's okay.
I got you multitasking.
It's okay.
You're the only one that could get away with that.
Yes.
All right. Number one. Question number one.
Hey,
folks.
And encourage them to. Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell them, babe.
Oh, yeah. Well, you guys can comment your answers on the hashtag PBT chat zone.
Órale. Okay, so question number one, what do you usually order at a Mexican restaurant, okay? What do you usually order at a Mexican restaurant? Like, every time, like, you go to the Mexican restaurant, what is the dish that you've ordered the most of the time? Because sometimes you mix it up a little bit, right?
Yeah.
Because if it's cold, pues te dejo un caldo, ¿entiendes?
Yeah.
So, babe, what is your... I have a feeling I think I know what it is.
Well,
I'm waiting to hear what you're going to say.
First of all...
And see if what you're going to say is what I'm thinking.
Yeah. So, first of all, I think that it just... You know how certain Mexican restaurants have, like, better carne guisada than others?
Mm-hmm.
You know, at this Mexican restaurant, you know, we get, you know, something
they're
else.
They're well known for this particular dish.
Yeah. So, but I think in general, I think what I usually order at a Mexican restaurant are enchiladas.
Enchiladas?
Yeah, enchiladas, rice, and beans. But like I said, there's certain Mexican restaurants where, like, I know I'm gonna go and order, like, chile rellenos, right? Because not every Mexican restaurant has the, you know, good chile rellenos, right? But for sure, I cannot go wrong with enchiladas. Like any type of enchiladas, like chicken enchiladas. I don't like cheese enchiladas, right? But chicken enchiladas, beef enchiladas. I tried fajita enchiladas, and I had never tried that before, but that was super good. Or enchiladas suizas, enchiladas verdes, or rojas.
I'm getting hungry.
I know. So enchiladas in general, like any enchiladas, because you can't go wrong. You know, you can't go wrong with enchiladas, rice, and beans, right? Yeah. So, yeah.
We took our some fans from
Yes. Alfredo Rios and Jenny Rios and Ali Vasquez, yes.
Yeah, we took them to this place called
El Rodeo.
El Rodeo. It's like an outdoor, you know, place. And we ordered some lunches, and they were like blown away with the lunches.
Yeah.
The fajita lunches, man, they were amazing. Mm-hmm. So, but let me counter on what you're saying, because
I know what you're going to say.
What?
I know what you're going to say. What am I going to say? You're going to say, but you get chalupas or tostadas.
And not just that.
But you're right, though.
Flautas.
Well, like, I like flautas, too.
Yeah. But out of flautas, tostadas, and enchiladas, and what was the other one you said?
Chalupas?
Chalupas, right? Yeah, chalupas. Well, those are tostadas, right?
Yeah, they're tostadas.
Out of those three, it's probably basically enchiladas more than that,
probably,
right?
Yeah. Yeah, enchiladas probably. Like, I have to really be in the mood for chalupas, right? But I do get chalupas a lot, too. But just to be on the safe side, I order chicken enchiladas, beef enchiladas, or ground beef enchiladas.
When I, sometimes when I get enchiladas, I get, you know, because they give you crackers and shit, right? But I'll ask them for tortillas de harina. And I'll put pedazos of enchilada in the tortilla de harina and eat it. And, man, it's great.
Double tortilla?
Yeah. Pues, ¿por qué no? Hardcore. We don't mess around. Oh, si la voy a cagar, la voy a cagar a toda madre. ¿Entiendes la onda?
Atáscate la vena.
Yeah. Why go halfway? Go all the way. Yeah. Or you'll put the whole enchilada in the tortilla if it's big enough, right?
And make it into a taco?
And then put rice and beans in there. En un taco de enchilada, papá. Cállate la boca. Shut up. Sale a toda madre.
Victoria Garcia, she says a Mexican plate. I never get a Mexican plate, though. But but she's right, though, because a Mexican plate usually has a little bit of what we just said. So it has enchiladas, and then it has like a little taquito. It has chalupa.
Una tostada.
Yeah, it has a little bit of everything. Mm-hmm. But no, I don't, right? I don't get that. I usually just get enchiladas or chalupas. It's the chalupas deluxe that I usually get. It has like sour cream, little tiritas of avocado. But yeah, that's right. I don't. But yeah, Mexican plate is still amazing. I mean, I'll eat. Mm-hmm. I'm a good eater. I eat whatever. I'm not picky. So
yeah.
Well, so what do you usually order at a Mexican restaurant?
Well, hold on a second, because this song came on from Pita Studio, and I love this stuff. Man. Let's lower down the lights and just hold each other, baby. And dance. And squeeze each other so hard.
Hasta que tú ya no me quieras. Hasta que digas hasta siempre.
This reminds me of when I was a kid and my parents would have friends over, but they were drinking outside, barbecuing.
And they would play this music?
Well, yeah. At the end of the night, I'll never forget, they were like, they moved the coffee table.
Yeah.
And they were all dancing. They had the stereo. They were all dancing in the middle of the living room. The stuff like this. La voz.
Porque yo estaría a tu lado en las buenas y en las malas, en los días más bonitos, en las noches más amargas, porque yo estaría a tu lado desde hoy hasta la muerte.
That's true.
Estaremos viejos juntos, siempre, siempre iré a quererte. Porque yo estaría a tu lado, estés contento, estés llorando. Cuando hacemos el amor, también si estamos peleando. Porque yo estaría a tu lado, desde hoy hasta la muerte. Siempre iría a quererte.
Aquí vamos a estar todos viejitos haciendo hashtag PBT, baby, ya sabes.
JC El Jefe Vasquez says, if this is plain, I'll order her strawberries and oysters. Right? It sounds like that.
Yeah. Yo estaré a tu lado. That's Pete Astudillo, man. Amazing voice and amazing talent. Don't forget, Tuesday night, we had the interview. You can check it out. All right. So, mine. This is going to freak everybody out. Because no matter what time of day we go to the Mexican restaurant, out of... And not every, I guess not every Mexican restaurant has breakfast all day.
Right, yes. Yeah, that's true.
But if it's 4 p.m, whatever, I usually order migas with French fries and beans. And what I order migas, right, yes. With egg white.
Yes.
Tráigame unas migas con el claro del huevo, con French fries y unos frijoles. Y tráigame... Y póngale un huevo estrellado arriba de las migas, which is an over medium egg on top of the migas, so the juice gets involved with that stuff, you know, the egg.
And when he orders, he does all those gestures.
Yeah.
You do.
I talk with my hands.
Yeah, you do. Well, because you want them to get it right.
Yeah. And so, you know, I mean, I think the majority of the times when I go to a Mexican restaurant, which is the one that we go to always, right?
All SP&T's. The time,
and
yes.
The ones we go to, the mom and pops, are usually the ones that have breakfast all day. And, mm-hmm. And sometimes they'll say, pues cobramos un extra dollar or $2. No hay pedo. Okay. Tráeme lo que quiero, ¿verdad?
Yes.
So, ordeno las migas con el claro del huevo y French fries, frijoles, refritos, y también les digo que le pongan un huevo over medium arriba de las migas, así para hacerle el juguito en yaqueas.
Uh-huh.
Unas tortillas de harina, porque pues, you know, I'm not watching my health or anything like that, or my weight, you know, so. Y si les queda salsa de la mañana, tráigame la salsa, ¿verdad? Because the breakfast sauce is a lot different than the evening sauce.
For sure.
The breakfast sauce tiene pedacitos de cebolla, and it's a little more tomato-y, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
And it reminds me of the sauce that my grandma used to make. Mi abuelita, mm-hmm. Le dije a mi abuelito, ve tráeme unos chiles de la mata de afuera. So my grandpa would go, and he would pick chilitos, and he'd have a handful. And then my grandma had this little special pan, little one. She'd put it in there, and then... My grandpa would blend it all together with tomato, and my grandma would put it in the little sartén with oil, and she'd have us all around the house going.
Yes, that's true. That's true. Yes.
Look at that. The smoke of the chile, man, was like, God, yeah. That's some good shit right there.
Yeah.
So we'd walk into the house and we'd be caught. My grandma, no le tocaba nada. My grandpa también se estaba en la mesa. Man, no le, it didn't bother him one bit. But us kids, we'd walk in there.
Yeah.
That's what I do, man, in the Mexican restaurants.
Janie Rio says that she eats migas with tortillas and that her husband thinks she's crazy. So does Rock, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah, he tacos does too.
And yes. A little bit of cheese too. You
yes, know. Mario Flores says Junction serves all day. Are they open?
Well, yeah, Junction Cafe.
Are they? No, I mean, are they open like right now after we're done?
Well,
with
we
the
used
show?
To go after the shows, remember?
Well, yes, I know.
Remember when the lady, now, it was real funny, the waitress there, she's
yes,
so funny.
I love her. I swear, I want to go right now just to go say hi to her and take her a shirt.
I hope she's still there.
I know. Yes,
but one definitely. Time we went over there and it was like,
at Junction
it
Cafe
was after
in
midnight.
Far.
We were coming, veníamos de un baile, de un concert, o que sea que, and we went uh-huh. to Junction Cafe. Far and the lady, she's always me hace pedo,
bien ¿verdad? Coqueta with Rock,
bien coqueta bien conmigo. Coqueta. Y le dije, oye, ¿tienen pastel? Sí, pineapple. I said, ah, bueno, pues tráeme un pastel de pineapple. So she comes back and she brings me, and it's apple pie. And I'm like, hey, este no es piña. Yo no dije piña. Yo dije pineapple. So she was saying apple pie, but I thought she was saying pineapple.
Yes. But you said pineapple. Okay, you know, traenos pineapple, right? So
yeah.
She's like, ah, bueno, ahorita vengo. So she goes and she comes back and You're like, what?
Y mis taste buds y mi lengua ya estaban preparadas para pineapple, ¿entiendes? So llegó el apple y dije, pues qué chicas, yo no quiero apple. Pues dice, no te dije que era pineapple, yo te dije que era pineapple.
I love her. She's so cute.
Yeah. So, anyway. Yeah,
Sally J signs everywhere. Yo quiero pineapple.
She was there.
We were cracking up. And so she's like, so the waitress is there. And she, you tell her, right? You tell her that. And she's like, pues, cómatelo. Like, too bad. She already cut it for you. She brought it to you. So just too bad. You're going to have to eat it. Of course, we ate it.
Of course,
right?
Yeah.
Because we have such a bad sweet tooth after we eat like a huge meal, but it was hilarious. Pineapple, yes. Pineapple. Nunca te dije piña. Oh,
we make sure when we eat bad, we don't just, you know, let our cholesterol and, you know, go up and all that stuff. We also make sure that, and our blood pressure with the salt and all that, we also make sure our sugar levels go up as well. You know, we want to stay even, you know, with everything. You know what I'm saying?
We got to make it fair.
All right. So that was question number two. We have any people saying what they order?
Yes. Let me see. Let me go down. Right
up. Yo quiero pineapple. Yes. No te dije apple pie. Yo dije pineapple.
Yes. Chorizo and eggs with papas y frijoles.
Yeah.
Oh, I love. That's what I get too.
Yeah, that's Rally's breakfast.
I get too. I get that chorizo, yeah. Eggs, papas, and frijoles on the side. But I ask them for a little bit of yellow cheese on top, just a little bit, not too much. Let me see.
Chilaquiles.
Chilaquiles.
That's some good stuff too, man. With that sauce.
Yeah. Someone else said migas too.
Yeah, migas. Se me sube el colesterol, mamacita, sube.
Michael Torres says chicken nuggets with rice and beans.
What?
I don't know. He's cracking up.
El colesterol. Nomás hablando de la comida se me subió el colesterol, yeah, a mí.
Bacon, potato, and egg taco, and Twinkies. Oy. Man. Oy.
Oy, oy, oy.
Ando bien malo.
Ando bien malo.
Ya me dijo el doctor muy en serio que de kilo ya estoy pasadito. No más grasa ni azúcar ni harina, ni más golosinas que me hacen gordito.
Todo para arriba.
No más grasa ni azúcar ni harina, ni más golosinas.
No más grasa, harina.
Con mi colesterol en 300. El antojo casi me domina.
Hijo es.
Chaparrita con amor me grita desde la cocina. Y pa' colmo mi piel chaparrita con amor me grita desde la cocina.
¿Quieres que te guise un chicharrón, un pedazo de jamón, o prefieres pollo frito, mi amorcito?
Oh,
mi sabroso chicharrón, tu pollito y tu jamón, pero ahorita nada de eso, cariñito.
No puedo.
¿Qué es lo que te pasa, corazón? Siempre has sido comelón y hoy te me pones tus moños, mi gordito.
No, muchas gracias, pero no, que el doctor ya me ordenó que me faje el cinturón. Es que me sube el colesterol, mi amorcito.
Me sube el colesterol.
Que me sube el colesterol, mamacita.
Me sube el colesterol.
Es que me sube el colesterol, mi chaparrita.
Me sube el colesterol.
Es que me sube el colesterol.
Bien intenso.
Mi puchunguita.
Me sube el colesterol.
Y esto va para todos los gorditos.
Hey. Para todos los gorditos en el chat zone. All right, the next question. Question number two. What is your favorite carnival ride? All right.
Oh, my gosh.
Después de que comes.
Oh, my gosh.
After eating that food, what is your favorite carnival ride? Right?
Am I first?
Yeah, you're first, baby.
Okay.
Which, you are a chicken. You don't get on too many.
What?
Well, I got you on one, but you regretted it, but okay, go ahead.
Which one?
Well, we'll tell you in a bit.
Ah, sorry, guys. Ay, Diosito. Sorry, guys. The Ring of Fire or the boat? What is it called?
That big old boat that goes like that?
Yeah, that one's okay. But the Ring of Fire is really, like, exhilarating for me.
Which is a Ring of Fire?
It's the one. It's kind of like that little roller coaster. It's literally a ring.
Is it like the Super Loop?
It
was called the Super Loop. It goes vroom, vroom.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah. And then it goes around in a circle. Yes. So I remember it was called the Ring of Fire, but it could be that too. It's the same thing. So yeah, something happened. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. My finger kind of pressed the.
El Oscar Cantu dice el zipper. Le gusta el zipper. Oye, te gusta el zipper, Oscar? Cálmate, bro.
The last time I was on the zipper, I think it was with my nephew. It was scary. The noise of like everything just moving, I thought it was going to fall apart. So I won't ever ride the zipper again. But the Ring of Fire is okay. I feel a little bit more secure and like strapped in. But remember that one time that we went to Fiesta Texas and we made it a point that
to get on everything.
We made it a point to get on every single ride. And I think we even bet. We even had a bet and we said, you know, once you start dropping like flies, pues ni modo, you're out.
Yeah.
So, I think I won that bet.
No.
Yeah. I felt super sick afterwards. We went back to the hotel.
So did I. Look, ladies and gentlemen, this is a trip because we got on all the rides. Mm-hmm. I mean, like all the hairy rides.
Yes.
It was like the Superman and all the three different roller coasters. And then the one that goes like super fast. And, everything was cool. We finished. I was like, orale, everybody gave. And then we went to the room and I was laying down and I would close my eyes and I got like, oh my God. It didn't hit me till I laid down in the hotel room and closed my eyes to go to sleep.
Yeah.
It had like, I had an after effect, like an aftertaste from an ugly beer. You know, it was like, it was bad. And I was like, oh, my God, I can't throw up. I can't throw up. I don't want to throw up. But I was this far from throwing up in the middle of the night because every time I closed my eyes to fall asleep, everything would start whirling around.
Yes,
but it was pretty scary. But one time, so your favorite is the Ring of Fire?
Yes, mine is the Ring of Fire. Yes. At a carnival. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Someone's saying like the little teacups, the bumper cars. Yeah, those are cute too. The Ferris wheel is super cute too. But I like, you know, something more exhilarating and like,
My favorite is the Himalaya, which is that's what it was called.
Oh yeah.
It's the one that goes around and it got music going on and then you wanna go faster. You wanna go faster. And then it stops and then it starts going backwards, right? It starts going backwards. And usually the person that's like on the edge of the seat gets squashed by
time.
The other two, right? And so that's always been my favorite since I was a kid. Mm-hmm. But the last time we went to the Rio Grande Valley Livestock Show, we decided to get on some rides. It was me, you, and Felicia. Mm-hmm. And I think it was just us three, right? And somebody else was with us. Was Ronnie with us or not?
No, I don't remember. It was at
or it was Felicia and a friend of hers, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Yes, it was. It was because her friend got real sick.
Got real sick. Yeah, Jackie, I think her name was. Mm-hmm. So we went and I said, hey, let's get on this one. So we had to wait in line. And so we finally got on all together. And it was like one of these that has like three seats and they're like separate. And then they just go around like that.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So when I get there, I had a cap on, right? And I'm getting on. And then the guy, the DJ that's running the show, right? That's pushing the buttons for the speed. He tells me, I'm going to bet you $100 that I can get that cap to fly off. Right?
Remember? He said it on the
microphone.
On the microphone, like on the entire PA system where everyone heard.
Right away, I think he like recognized me or he either saw you and said, I'm going to make this guy look like a fool next to that hot chick. and that's basically what I think would happen.
That's what happened.
Because these carnival guys, they're not from around here. They don't know who the hell I am. Mm-mm. Right? And so this guy probably saw me with Rally and said, let me make this guy a fool.
Like, let me embarrass him. Let me embarrass him.
So he called me out and he said, I got $100. I'm going to get that hat fly off of your head.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, bring it on. And chingon time, bring it on.
Yeah, you were mad. I mean, dude, you were like irked by it.
That was the longest ride we've ever been on.
Yes.
And he put it like to 11, I think.
Yes.
And
it never finished.
It never finished. And my cab never fell down. Yes.
And it slowed down. And I'm like, okay, it's over. That's it. Like, I can't take it anymore. I was really, we were on the verge of just like, I was about to pass out. And then as we're twirling still, you know, slowly it starts going backwards and it starts getting faster and faster and faster. And then you start yelling. I don't know what you were yelling. I'm like, stop it.
Because we would pass by there and I'd look at him and I'd go, whoa, it's still on, man. It's still on.
You were taunting him. And so
and you were like,
oh,
stop
really?
It. Stop. Yes. Stop. Yes. So I kept taunting him every time we would pass by the window where he was.
Yeah.
And then and Felicia and her friend were in another one.
They were like.
And after that. They were like, oh, what happened? And then Felicia says that Jackie asked her, why isn't it stopping? And Felicia told her, I bet it's my dad.
Oh, my God.
I bet it's my dad. So we got off of there. And I was like, I was kind of like a little bit like this, right? Walking. And then we walked and we went towards the side of behind some carnival rides.
Uh-huh.
I think we're already gonna head out because we had had enough already, and Jackie started getting sick, and you started like, oh my God, I'm feeling sick.
Yes.
So the after effects, it doesn't happen right away, but it happens. Mm-hmm. But nombre, I was like, man, that dude couldn't get my hat off. Yo chingue, carnal, lo que sepas. No me chingas, güey.
Competitive.
Me ganas. Bring it on. Goodness. And you know, it was fun because we got our money's worth for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we were on that ride. My favorite ride's the Himalayas. Yours is the Ring of Fire. And we have, let me see here, Dario Puig, Carnies. I used to work with those dudes, man. Every time the carnival came down, I'd go help them put up a ride, and they'd pay me. Yeah. Let's see here.
Let me go up because they were saying some over here.
Mira, she's El Dario Puig, está hablando de alguien de Sweden, una girl de Sweden, puro Swedish erotic, El Dario, no?
Well, I Noah Garza says, Raleigh, where are you from? Oh. And Dario says she's from Sweden.
Oh.
I don't know. I missed all of that.
Oh, I am correct. Swedish erotica.
Yeah, you could see. The Himalaya, the Genesis.
Teacups para los viejitos.
Para los viejitos. Who says that? Child in the house, I bet. Bien burlista.
The Himalaya, always play heavy music, yeah.
Yes, that was it. And that's, I think, why you gravitated towards that one.
Probably.
Because you're like, oh, let's go to this one. This is jamming out.
All right. So we got one more question. Mm-hmm. Let's go. What's your favorite 80s song, all right? Now, we're kind of fearful of this one because we're afraid we might play a song and then they'll, you know, block us. But I've already figured it out, folks. Like, when they block our live stream because of a copyright song or something, now I can go on the internet on my YouTube studio and I can edit out that little piece that killed our show. And they'll pop it right back up, except we won't be able to go into the chat zone. Or see what all the chat was about.
I know. That's the only thing I'm like, oh, if you edit it with the YouTube studio, it deactivates the live chat.
Yeah.
So, but that's
so,
okay.
So we're going to be very careful here. Mm-hmm. If we do just like fall off the space, fall off the face of the earth, you know, it's because we played a song that was copywritten already. So it's only going to be two songs anyway. Right. Mm-hmm. So what's your favorite 80s song, babe?
Mine has to be Don't Stop Believing from Journey.
I don't think that's one of them that
I hope it's not. I hope they should do something to where like it'll tell you this may block your video, like a little warning, but they don't warn you.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it.
Let's see if it's this one. Yeah.
Dario Puig, Too Many. Yes, I agree. I had a list of like five or six. I'm like, eh.
My favorite 80s song is, I'm afraid it might be the one that might block us. I don't know.
No.
Living in a lonely world. He took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy. Born and raised in South Detroit, he took the midnight train going anywhere.
The guitar. Miguel Ramirez is Bad to the Bone. That's George Thorogood. Jefe, El Jefe, Back in Black. AC/DC. That barely made the 80s, bro. It was 1980.
Yeah.
Eye of the Tiger, Oscar Cantu. Yeah, that's a cool song right there, man. Eye of the Tiger from the Rocky movie.
Mm-hmm.
One of the biggest songs from Survivor. They had a couple of other badass songs that I liked as well.
Air Supply, Mark Anthony.
Check out these Survivor songs. I don't. Let me see if you all will recognize any of these.
Cool in the Gang. Javier Cardenas, hello, what's up? Okay.
This one.
I love that song, Rick Gonzalez.
Survivor. I like this album.
Mm-hmm.
There's a story in my eyes. Vital Signs is the name of the album.
Mm-hmm.
Turn the pages of desire.
Puro 80s esa rola.
Now it's time to train Master those Puppet dreams on Guerra.
This one. This is another song off the album. I sang in a top 40 band in 1985, and we used to do this song. It was called, the band was, I forgot the name. We used to rehearse in Hidalgo in some old house. I was living in Harlingen because I was going to school in Harlingen because I'd gotten kicked out of Mercedes and Mission.
Mm-hmm.
And so I ended up in Harlingen, and I was living with my aunt, que paz descanse. And I would take the bus to Hidalgo and just to rehearse with these guys. Split Image was the name of the band. And we did this song. And then the first time we performed was at a place called the Catholic War Veterans in between Mercedes and Westlake.
Uh-huh.
And they gave us a shot to, you know, open up for a band there. I think it was New Variety, maybe. I don't know who it was. So we went and we played this song. And I sang it and I was off key through the whole song. It was horrible. The worst thing ever. And I thought, man, what was wrong with me? Why couldn't I get in the key? Well, it happened to be that the keyboardist had started the song in the whole wrong key.
So
the way we rehearsed it was not the way we were. So it was his fault, you know, but and there was just no way I could get into it. This is another song from this album.
Sally J Signs Everywhere says time after time, especially because it comes out on Romy and Michelle's high school reunion.
This one, I love this one from Survivor too.
Summer 69. Can I convince you what you see is real?
Who am I to blame you? Survivor's a good band.
What you feel, I was always
reaching. You were just a girl. I wish I could play piano like that. I took for
granted the friend I have in you. I was living
for a dream. Loving for The Search Is Over is the name of this one. I think this is where it comes in. Now I look into your eyes. I can see forever. The search is over. You were with me all the while.
Romy.
The Post-it women?
Yes, I invented Post-its.
I invented Post-it. Cállate.
I love it. Lying in my bed, hear the clock tick. You know how when they're in the reunion, like at the actual reunion,
uh-huh,
and like they dance together?
Mm-hmm.
Me and my sister know the dance.
See? The one where they do all these moves.
Yeah. We would do it all the time.
We need together. To film it and put it on hashtag
we'll
PBT.
Do it. We're so silly.
Time after some time.
Let me pick my song because we got to get going.
Yes. What's your favorite 80s song?
Let's see if we don't get banned for this one.
Let's hope not. Cross your fingers. Vogue by Madonna. La Menina Nena. La Menina Nena. Actually, she just said Vogue, Madonna, but she also said La Chica Que Sonia.
You know what? A lot of people are probably thinking that my favorite 80s song is going to be a rock song. And it's not.
Uh-oh.
But it could be because it's got a lead solo on it. And
I think I know.
I just love the that's this song. When I hear it, it like I hear so many elements in the song, and the lead solo, the arrangement, the melody, and every time I hear it, it takes me right back to the 80s, man, big time. And here it is, man. Let's check it out. Let's just cross our fingers. The guitar. The lead solo on this album is great, on this song. Let me move it to the lead solo real quick here.
Dario Quick says really rock.
Yeah, dude. Oh, he says he's impressed.
Yeah. LOL.
These guys are great. Right here, right here. The sound, the tone of the guitar. Ooh, that high. Right here, the guitar. This song reminds me of my primo Edwin and his carnal.
Eugene.
Because when I first bought that Camaro that I had, the Mustang that I had when I met you.
Yes.
I had, it was a 2006?
No.
Or 2005?
It was a 2005.
Yeah, it was a GT, Mustang GT, beautiful car. And by the way, Jesse Turner.
Uh-oh, we're going there.
Wrecked into it. That's a whole other story.
Yeah, it's an awesome story.
I think we talk about it on the interview I do with Jesse Turner.
Yes, you guys do.
He had this van that he had his van, and he went to my apartment, and was a parking space. He decides to park next to my Mustang and hits it.
But does he tell you about it?
Yeah. So I had that Mustang, right? And, man, I love that Mustang. It was great. And it had a system in it. Damn. So me and my cousins, Edwin and Eugene, were out cruising around because Eugene was going to get married. So it was like, we're going out. Yeah. But before he got married, we were going out every weekend. I was taking him with me everywhere. And we were driving around, and the song was freaking full blown loud on my car, and it sounded great. So I was just sobering. I was checking out, make sure I don't put a song where. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's my favorite song. I hope you all liked it. And that's going to do it for us. We got to go eat.
Yes.
Right?
Are we doing a giveaway? Yeah, yeah, let's do it. Let's do a giveaway.
Okay.
So.
Let's give out one of these and we'll give a Dr. T's primary care.
Yeah, and I'll throw in some little t-shirt, stylus, the pens.
And those t-shirts are awesome.
They're so comfy. Super comfy. Hold on. So this is our hashtag PBT Patreon pledge giveaway.
Yes. Woo-hoo. Vale.
Okay, let's do it.
All right. So let me see here. Let me hear this song right. Oh.
Mario Flores says Junction should be open, so it better be, Mario.
Yeah, let's do this one, Lowrider, man. This is I'm just trying not to play a song that we might get us banned for.
Yes.
Oh, here's an 80s song I remember. Mm-hmm. Right here. Let's play this one.
Uchi Wallace.
And Lady Murphy.
I was jamming out to the other one already.
Sorry. Okay. Okay, the winner of this week's Patreon. The Patreon member that's a winner.
Let's see, let's see.
Roel Velasquez.
Roel! Is he from Corpus?
Yeah, he's from Corpus.
Roel Velasquez, congratulations.
All right, we're going to send you a package, bro.
For sure.
Congratulations. Now, if you want to be part of that, join our Patreon club. A $25 pledge gets you automatically a free t-shirt, a hashtag PBT t-shirt that nobody else has. I've been asked for those shirts out there in the street, and I can't give them to them. I can't sell them to them. You have to be part of this Patreon pledge.
Yes.
So, excuse me.
Ding.
So you get a special hashtag PBT t-shirt and sticker, and you have the chance of winning on our hashtag PBT weekly drawings for prizes, which is what we just did right now.
Yes.
Roel Velasquez from Corpus won, man.
Woo!
All right, patreon.com is where you got to go. Search Rock and Roll James PVT, okay? And if you do join, whether you do the $3 or $9 or $25, now $3 and $9, we'll still send you something. Stickers, we're working on some stickers, but we got koozies and stuff like that, so that we'll still give you something. But for the $25 pledge, you get the t-shirt, okay? Mm-hmm. And then all of y'all fall into that little bucket of names, okay? So send us your address. If you do the $25 pledge, send us your t-shirt size. Okay, with the address. All right, we also have Cash App, $ Rock and Roll James. Thank you to Jimmy Vasquez, Copper's Cove TV, Texas. Why did I say TV? Copper's Cove, Texas.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Felipe and Alex in Round Round, Texas. Round Round,
Texas. Yes, they're the ones that send us the big donut. And they're the ones that gave you the little Dallas Cowboy helmet back.
Yeah, it's
so
back
thank
there.
Thank you guys so much. And he was the one that was eating the caldito de res and he was watching the show. So, Felipe, thank you so much. And Alex's wife as well.
Yeah, it's right over there next to the Diary of a Madman album, one of my favorite Ozzy albums. I was watching YouTube earlier and I was watching a concert of Ozzy at the US Festival, 1982, 83. And Jakey Lee was with them and they were playing some music off of that album, you know, because... this guitarist had died, right? Was killed in a plane accident. Uh-huh. Randy Rhoads. But man, Jakey Lee, boy. Let me see here.
We also want to thank Carmen Benavides as well. She also sent us a donation through Cash App. So thank you so much, Carmen Benavides. Enjoy your menudo.
Also, and by the way, if you want a shirt, get that a Tuesday shirt. Right.
Yes.
And we're gonna start a contest. Hopefully, on Tuesday we'll let you know about it. We gotta set it all up.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And you can Cash App is $30. And if you do Cash App is $30, and you want the shirt, put the size of the shirt and your address. Mm-hmm. And it's small, medium, large, extra large, and double XL.
Yes. Okay? Yes.
Also, we have Venmo at Rock and Roll James, which not many people utilize. We don't get much action on that one. And PayPal as well. Donation. Thank you to Simon Godina from Delavan, Wisconsin.
Simon and Eva Godina. Yes, both of them.
Yeah. And by the way, we have a post office box. That's where they've been sending us stuff, but we haven't been able to put it up yet.
Oh, yes.
Do you know it offhand, baby?
I
we'll do it on Tuesday.
We'll do it on Tuesday so that way I can make
we're
going to
make
a
graphic. We're going to make a graphic and everything in case you want to mail us stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, even a postcard from where you're at so we can show
and
it.
And a little while ago, we had one of our fans from Del Rio, Texas. He messaged us on our 641-3241 number And he asked, can I get y'all's address so I can send you guys something? So I sent him a screenshot of our little business card, little thing that we had. So, yeah, if you guys want to send us a text, if you all want the address, I can send it to you right away. So it's 956-641-3241, and we can give you the address to our mailbox. But for sure, by Tuesday, we'll have a little graphic up for it.
All right. Once again, hashtag PBT Saturday Night Live, Saturday Night Party Live. It was from my PBT Network Studios, brought to you by Dr. T's Primary Care for Men. IV vitamin infusion therapy, testosterone, COVID tests, or Morellin. And on Thursday, it's for women. Call them at 956-441-2188. And just tell them, hashtag PBT Rock and Roll James sent you. Okay? So they've been asking for me to do some karaoke, and they've been back by popular demand.
Woo!
Yes. Let me see here. Karaoke.
Juan Guerra Barbacoa and Big Red in the morning. Yes. Mine is the Big Red. I like my coffee. I'm a big coffee drinker on weekends especially. So Anthony Garcia, JC El Jefe. JC El Jefe says good night. Hashtag PBT family. Mm-hmm. Alfredo Rios, good night everyone. Mario Flores, good night. Sally J signs everywhere. See y'all later. Javier Cardenas.
Mm-hmm. All right. So we're going to try this.
Yes.
Saludito para el jefe.
El suegro.
Y vamos a ir a pegarle a un Mexican restaurant 24 hours, ojalá.
Yes, I hope. Mario says it was open, so we're going to go check it out, Mario.
Sally J signs everywhere on our waiter for a late night snack at your house.
Meet us at Junction.
Te imaginé en mi soledad hasta llegar a adivinar tus suaves manos y tu caminar. Me impregné de ti, me olvidé por ti, porque sabía que tú ibas a llegar.
La chica que soñé
es realidad.
La chica que soñé
toda mi vida.
La chica que soñé
hoy estoy abrazándome, porque eres la chica que soñé. Para Lupe Bernabé.
Yes, we're going to the first baile that there is.
Yeah.
For sure.
Los Cuatitos Cantú, Lupe.
Oh, remember that cumbia that we liked from Los Cuatitos Cantú, remember?
Yeah, yeah.
Janie Rios, you looked like this guy back in the day. We have a video. If I would have known you were going to sing it, I would have put the video of you and him at the flea market.
Next to each other. Okay. Mi memoria te invité, en el verde te dibujé, tu pelo suelto y doradita piel. Era un soñador, esperando el amor, sin conocerte yo te di, me enamoré.
La chica que soñé
es realidad. Estoy abrazándome, tú eres la chica que soñé, es realidad.
La chica que soñé
es realidad.
La chica que soñé
es realidad. Good night, y'all.
La chica que soñé.
Y'all have a good one. God bless you.
Let me say bye, too.
Sústame one time.
Bye, everyone. Thank you guys for hanging out with us. Mwah. We'll see you on Tuesday.
Tuesday, papa. Sústame one time. Vámonos, Recio.
Woo.
noche. Y esto es La Chica Que Soñé.